Choosing how to market yourself can be difficult and confusing for small businesses.
There are so many options: social media, ad banners, email marketing, SEO. It's hard to know where your money is going to work best.
Don't ignore print. It continues to get results. Even with all the digital alternatives, it remains a great return on investment.
And one of the hardest working bits of printed marketing collateral around is the Trifold brochure. Stick around and we'll show you how to make one in under 10 minutes. Hi, I'm Maddie.
I'm Jo, and we're design educators at Canva.
We're releasing new videos every week on the Canva channel, so make sure you subscribe below so you don't miss out.
So Maddie, what's so good about Trifold brochures?
Well, they live in that magic place between the brevity and impact of a postcard and the storytelling capacity of a booklet.
I love them because you can fit so much into a small asset. There's space for a big, bold, eye-catching cover and space to talk about your business's story or products or both.
The simple trifold design is actually brilliant from a design perspective. It gives you 6 different areas to utilize, which makes it easy to break up content and fit heaps in. Or you can combine different areas for a larger, more impactful visual.
I also love how the trifold brochure reveals information to you. It has a cover. This then opens up to a spread, which you can then further open to a full-size page. So it makes it really easy to plan an audience's journey through the information. And you still have another panel on the back, perfect for a clear call to action, relevant links, or contact information.
Yeah, there's really so much you can do with a trifold brochure. So shall we jump into Canva and start building one?
Let's do it.
Cool. If it's your first time designing a trifold brochure and you're not sure which direction to go, start inspired with a template.
Canva templates are a game changer. For those just starting their design journey, they offer a guiding hand, inspiration for ideas, and they'll show you design theory in practice. For experienced designers, they offer a shortcut. With existing design elements, you can jump in and customize them to suit your needs.
Yeah, that's right. So, Jo, give me a client to design for.
Off the top of my head.
Yeah.
How about dentistry?
Okay.
I'm thinking smile dentists.
Perfect. Okay, I'll grab this template. It's for a medical center, but I'll show you how you can quickly modify it for what you need. One thing about brochures that can be confusing is the order of the panels.
And if you're not careful, you only realize once you've printed and folded them to find out that your front cover isn't actually on the front.
Yeah, it's a bit counterintuitive, but the front cover is the right panel on the top page, the back cover is the middle panel, and the left panel is the inside flap. The bottom page from left to right is all the inside pages. That's the easiest to remember.
It can be a good idea to number your panels while you're designing so you can keep track of what information needs to go where and to make sure the order and flow make sense.
Yeah, while the front, back and flap are more defined areas, the inside pages can be treated as 3 distinct panels. Or you can play around with different arrangements, like treating the inside as one huge collective spread. So Jo, what's your typical process for customizing templates?
I start with text. I move on to imagery, and then I look at whether I need to use other design elements to create balance or fill in any gaps in the design. How about you, Maddie?
Yeah, for print assets, I agree. Balance is so important. So I'll make sure there's enough negative space and flow between the text while maintaining visual balance across the brochure panels. One thing I want to do is move the Our Services section. So I want it to be on the first inside flap you see when you open the cover.
That makes sense. It's probably what the audience really needs to find out.
Yeah. So putting it here means it sits across from the About Us panel. It's really showing why the dentistry is the right choice.
I love the picture you've chosen.
Thanks. Again, because of the way the trifold works, the audience will only see the dentist and the bear. Their curiosity will get them to open it up and we'll see what's really happening. Here, I think I'll add in some of the smiling team too.
Nice. It doesn't take long to customise, does it? What about the back? It looks a bit empty.
Yeah, sometimes it's good to leave some space on the back in case the client needs to add some additional information that might change periodically, like specials, for example. Or if there are a number of practices, you might leave space so they can stamp their individual contact details.
Back covers often get forgotten, but there's a 50% chance that it might be the side showing when the brochure is put down.
Yeah, that's right, good point. So, okay, let's put some customer quotes and endorsements on the back.
A question I get asked a lot about is image usage rights. If you're using someone else's images, check that they're licensed for print assets to avoid any headaches after you've gone ahead and gotten the brochure printed.
Yeah, and alternatively, you can utilise Canva's expansive image library, which is full of royalty-free images. There are some images in Canva's library that you need to pay to use. You'll recognise them because they have a little crown next to them.
Pro users get access to these, but you can search from the Elements tab and apply filters that only show the free to use options.
Yeah, and I love that you can filter using a color too. This will only show you photos that are primarily using this color. I feel like blue is common in dentists, so what about if we select orange?
Oh, that's cool. That'll make it much easier to find images that match your branding.
So there we are. A brochure for smile dentists is ready to be printed.
Canva makes printing your brochure super easy. You can customise and print directly from the Canva editor. Can I show you how?
Yeah, sure.
In the top right, click Print Trifolds. Make sure you choose double-sided. Select your finish, matte, gloss or uncoated, and think about how the brochure is going to be used. If you need to write on it or put a stamp on it, you don't want to choose gloss. Put your quantity in here, then click Continue. Next, Canva prompts you to proof your design to check it's print safe.
This means checking your edges, so just making sure there's enough safe space around those edges, and proofreading your text for any errors. The aim is to make sure you are not sending something off to print that has mistakes on it. That's costly and frustrating.
Fill in your shipping details and then complete payment for your printing. And that's it. It'll turn up on your doorstep in no time.
As you can see, playing with printed assets can be a lot of fun. Canva helps take the confusion and fear out of it so you can focus on really selling the benefits of your business.
Whether you're a dentist or any other business, Trifold brochures really allow you to get a lot of information across to your prospective customers in a cost-effective and visual way.
Yeah. Smile, Dentist Jo. Where did you come up with that?
Well, you put me on the spot. I almost said Egyptian Museum Exhibition.
Oh, that would have been pretty cool, actually.
Next time.
Thanks so much for watching. Remember to like and subscribe to get notified when more Canva content becomes available. Maybe I'll get the chance to give Jo the brief next time.
Sure thing. Keep watching for more tips and tricks, and happy designing.